Students, let's discuss work done by variable force. As we already studied, when a force is applied on a body and it produces some displacement, we say work is done. Like say, this body is pulled by a force F and say it is displaced by a displacement S. In this situation, we simply call work is equals to Fs. If it is applied in some different direction, it can be written as F dot S. Now, this relation can be used only when force is constant. If throughout the motion of displacement, force is constant, we can use it F dot S or Fs directly if they are in same direction. But if, in a particular case, if force is varying with displacement, at every displacement or in between the value of force is changing, then it is obvious we cannot directly use work as F into S, because for the whole or throughout displacement S, F was not a constant. So if we consider, if force is given as a function of X, if X is the distance or displacement covered by a body, in this situation at a particular position, say at X equals to X1, the force is applied on the body, which is varying with distance x as it is changing. Work done will also gradually or continuously change. And we wish to calculate the work done when body reaches position x2. Now, in this situation, when body was at a general position x, it would be experiencing force which is given as a function of x. Now, we can consider for an elemental displacement from x to x plus dx. There is such a small displacement in which we can consider that the force will not change significantly or it is almost constant in the neighborhood of this position x. So we can say in this elemental displacement, some work can be calculated as F into dx. So if we calculate work done in elemental displacement, dx is dw, then this dw can be written as f dx, or more precisely we can write f dot dx. This is the work done by the force and displacement of the body at a position x by a small displacement, very small elemental displacement dx. So if we wish to calculate the total work in displacement from x equals to x1 to x equals to x2, and this total work can be written as integration of dw, or it is integration of f dot dx within limits from x1 to x2, because we are displacing the body from x1 to x2. Be careful about this result, as whenever force is given to you as a function of x, you need to use this integration to evaluate the work done. And whenever forces are constant, you can directly use force multiplied by displacement or the dot product of force and displacement. Let's see an example for calculation of work by a variable force. Here we are given with a situation when a block is placed on x-axis at x equals to 1 meter and is saying a block of mass 5 kg is pulled by an external force which depends on its position as 4x square plus 2x plus 1 newton, and we are required to find the work done by this force in displacing the block to the position x equals to 2 meter. In this situation, as we are given that the force is a function of position x, so we can directly write the work done is equals to integration of f dx, and integration of f dot dx can be further written as f dx cos of 60 degree, because the body will be displaced along x-axis, force will be acting at an angle 60 degree. So this will become 1 by 2 cos 60 integration of f dx. F can be written as 4x square plus 2x plus 1 into dx, and the limits will apply from x equals to 1 to x equals to 2, because initially the body was located at x equals to 1 meter and we need to go to x equals to 2 meter. If we integrate it, very easily we can get it half integration of 4x square will become 4x cube by 3 plus integration of 2x will be x square plus x. Limits will apply from 1 to 2. On substituting the limits, we'll get half of, first we'll put the limit x equals to 2. On substituting limit x equals to 2, we'll be getting 8 into 4, it is 32 by 3 plus 4 plus 2 minus, we put the limit x equals to 1, that is 4 by 3 plus 1 plus 1. Now on solving, finally we'll get it 20 by 3 joule. That is the answer to this question. Let us discuss calculation of work using graphs. As we know, work can be given as integration of f dx from x1 to x2 if body is displaced from position x1 to x2. And this integration of f dx can be directly written as area under force displacement graph. If we are given with a force which is given as a function of position x, and if we plot this function, see the function goes like this. This is the graph of this function f is equals to f of x. In this situation, say if a body is displaced from position x1 to x2, we can simply state this integration of f dx can be given by directly the area under this fx curve between x-axis. This area can be directly written as work done. Because indirectly this area is representing the product of force into displacement, or a continuous product of force to displacement when body is displaced from position x1 to x2. We can directly also write, if we are given with a curve of force as a function of x, work can directly be written as area under fx curve. There's another way of calculation of work if you are given with the fx curve for a given situation under which a body is displaced by the given force.